It's not midnight, but I'm with a midnight's child. I'm with the gentleman who plays Salim Sinai in the film, but Satya. Satya Som, thank you so much for being with us and talking to Filmy Cafe.
Thank you for having me.
So you just landed last night,
mm-hmm.
and your big night is tomorrow night. It's premiering, the mm-hmm. world premiere at the Toronto International Film Festival. You've done this before,
mm-hmm.
but this is especially special.
Yeah. Yeah, it's extremely exciting. I mean, I think not only finally getting a chance to share this film, this labor of love that has been living in the hearts and minds of all of us for the last 3 years, but of people since someone wrote the book,
mm-hmm.
You know, the last 30 years ago. So not only is that exciting, but it's also wonderful to be able to do it in Toronto, which is such a multicultural city that really, I think, is excited for this story and really wants to see this film. So. Yeah.
Do you remember the first call that came from Deepa, or the first communication that you heard that she was considering you for this part?
Yes, I do. Well, I first met Deepa in Toronto, actually.
Mm-hmm.
I was here shooting another film, and I had done a play with an actor who she had worked with, and he said, look, you're going to be in Toronto.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you get lunch with Deepa? And I said, I'd love to. And I had heard that she was making this film, but I never really thought that I would be considered. I just kind of assumed I wasn't Indian enough, and I didn't, you know enough about it. And I said, that's fine. You know, Deepa's pretty much exclusively works with actors who live in India, mostly in her past films. And so I just kind of never really saw myself as a candidate. And I think that probably helped, because we met and I was really relaxed. I wasn't trying to impress
yeah.
her, or, you know, we were just chatting, and we really hit it off. And then it was, I went back to New York to do a play, and I came back to shoot again, and it was during that second time up here that Deepa said, look, I'd really like to get together with you. I really need to talk to you about something important. And
mm-hmm.
I was starting to be like, wait a second, could this be what I think it is?
Right.
And then she sort of whispered to me that yes, they were considering me for the role, that there were still some other people they were looking at, but
yeah.
they were considering me for the role, and that was incredibly exciting. I'd say it was a dream come true, but I didn't even dream that it would happen. So
right.
it was really thrilling, yeah.
So after being in consideration, after that conversation, when you get the call that you are going to be Salim Sinai,
mm-hmm.
what's your reaction?
Well, it wasn't a call, actually. What
yeah.
happened was I met Deepa and I met Salman, and we had spoken, and I knew that they both liked me and
mm-hmm.
liked the idea of me, but I also knew that they were meeting with some other people, and
right.
I didn't really get any more communication from them for a while. And then I was coming to, I had moved to Los Angeles, I was coming back for Thanksgiving, and Deepa said, look, there's a screening of my film,
mm-hmm.
Heaven on Earth, will you come to it, and we can
right.
talk about Midnight.
Mm-hmm.
I said, of course. And I turn up at the screening, and we watch the film, and then afterwards Deepa's doing a talk back with Ellen Burstyn,
mm-hmm.
And somebody in the audience asked, oh, I hear that you're directing Midnight's Children next. And Deepa said, yes, I am. And in fact, the young man who is going to be playing Salim is here in this audience. And I sort of looked around and said, wait, me? What? Really? I couldn't believe it. And I, you know, I was like at the back of this auditorium, and all of these faces turned around to look, and I was just like, oh my goodness.
This is happening.
And, you know, but to tell you the truth, I mean, you talk about this screening tomorrow, and in a way, this is happening is still happening for me. You know,
yeah.
that wonder, because even after you get offered a part, you know, so many films don't end up getting made. And even after a film gets made, so many things don't end up releasing. And even, you know, and so to be at this point with this film, I think we're all incredibly grateful and lucky.
Yeah.
And it really is a bit of a magic trick in itself.
Mm-hmm. You were offered the part, you accepted the part. How did you become the part?
That was a long process of research and development. You know, I had never lived in India. I was born in London and grew up in the States and in England. So there was a lot of work to be done to really be able to convincingly portray not only an Indian boy, but in a way, the Indian boy.
Yeah.
So I spent a lot of time in Bombay, just traveling around the city. I studied Hindi,
mm-hmm.
Which I had never spoken any of before.
Mm-hmm.
I read an incredible amount and, you know, really talked with Deepa a lot about this character. You know, Salim is a bit of an enigma. in the book. You hear about everybody else through him, but nobody tells you anything much about Salim. Mm-hmm. And so there was a lot of questions that we had. You know, who is this boy? What does he like to do? What are his hobbies?
Right.
And so I really collected little toys and a telescope. You know, mm-hmm. he decided, oh, he'd have a telescope. So I went to Crawford Market and looked around in the streets around there, and I found actually in Colaba Causeway is where I ended up finding this old telescope. Great, so we had that.
Mm-hmm.
And I wrote a lot. I wrote pages and pages just sort of from his perspective and from his mind. And so there was a lot of contextual work to do to kind of absorb the history of the country,
mm-hmm.
to absorb the body language, you know, which is completely different, and the way that even English is spoken, you know, not only accent, but also word usage, rhythm, things like that. So, yeah.
There's a young gentleman who plays the younger Salim mm-hmm. very finely before you take on mm-hmm. the part, Dashiel Safari.
Yeah.
Did you meet with him during the making? Did you guys connect and then, you know, take on the part from where he left off? Like, how did you go about making that transition?
Yeah, no, I met with Dashiel quite a lot. We spent a lot of time together. Actually, whenever I would buy one of these little presents for myself, I would buy double. I would buy one for him and one for me. And so when we first met, I sort of came with all of these gifts,
mm-hmm.
All of these little talismans of Salim Sinai. And so we met and we spent quite a lot of time together.
Right.
And just getting a sense of each other and sort of just becoming friends, really. And so that was, I think, very important for the role, the dual role.
Right.
Yeah.
How do you think he's done? Have you seen
I think he's fantastic. Yeah. He is fantastic. I have seen the film, and he really has a wonderful ability to both be grappling with these serious issues, but he's a kid, you know, and he's got this childlike effervescence, and I think that that duality is very present in Salim throughout his life and very important for this role.
The captain of this ship that you set sail on,
mm-hmm.
Midnight Sharon, Deepa Mehta, you were a fan of her work before working with her. What are your thoughts on working with her and the whole process of actually being a part of this film with her alongside mm-hmm. for it?
You know, Deepa's a wonderful filmmaker and a gift to any actor. She is an incredibly deeply felt person. I mean, Deepa, really, her emotions are just very present and very true, and she discusses them, she talks about her feelings, and that really extends to her artistic creation. She
mm-hmm.
is very, very connected to the emotions of her character, while also, and here's where the real magic is, while also being able to be spontaneous and be aware of things outside of the narrative, which when folded into the film, a little shot of a buffalo,
mm-hmm.
or a little moment of some children running into water, or a gecko on the wall, actually really contribute to this epic scale that you end up feeling. It's not, even though she's really pulled this through line of a coming of age story, which makes the film followable, you
mm-hmm.
know, and digestible, these other influences that she was always open to and keeping the corner of her eye open to, I think is what has given it its epic quality.
Were you a changed man at the end of this whole process of working on Midnight Sharon and being Salim Sinai? Were you changed?
I was deeply changed. I had been away from my family, from my friends, from my home, from my country for about 8 months, immersed in this extremely intense, I mean, it's very enjoyable, but very, very challenging, both logistically and emotionally, process. And I think that also this ownership of this part of my heritage, which I never really was very connected to. I mean, I adore my grandmother who lives in Bombay, and I've always had a nice time there, but feeling like a bit of a Bombay boy mm-hmm. is really a very cool and exciting side effect of having gone through this amazing process.
Well, we wish you all the very best for Midnight Sharon.
This
is your moment.
Thank you.
And may it last longer, much longer than midnight. So congratulations and all the very best.
Thank you very much. Love to meet you.
Thank you.